you journeyed out with the abortion service early this morning. Now, we pray to tear the hands of Sister Bob and praise God.
Amen.
Good morning.
Good morning.
May we all stand for the intro of worship.
Yeah.
by Rev. Hill.
Heard that the church say amen.
Amen.
Say it again.
Amen.
This is my story. This is my song.
Yes.
Praising my Savior.
Oh, yes.
All the day long.
Oh, yes.
Let us pray. Most holy, righteous, and mighty God.
Yes. Yes.
We come again in your presence and in your sight.
Yes, Lord.
Yes.
Thanking you, O God, for letting us see another day that we never seen before.
Oh, thank you.
We thank you, O God,
thank you,
for the blood that is yet running warm in our veins.
Yes, sir.
Realize, O God, you could have called us on to judgment.
Yes.
But you let us live on in the land of the living for just a little while longer.
Uh-huh. Yes.
We thank you, O God.
Thank you.
We thank you when we got up this morning. We couldn't get up on our own.
Well,
but with your angels,
uh-huh,
that lift us up off our sleeping bed as we slept last night,
yeah,
brought us to our feet,
yeah,
allowed us to put on our own garments one more time.
Yeah. Yeah.
Realize, oh God, we were able to go down to our breakfast table,
yeah,
and we were able to feed ourselves.
Yeah.
Realize, oh God, it's all because of you.
Yes, sir.
It's nothing that we can do without you.
Yeah.
Oh, Heavenly Father, help us,
yes,
as we go through the degrees of life.
Yes.
Sometimes we're burdened, sometimes we're loved. But Heavenly Father, I ask you right now in the name of Jesus.
Right now, Jesus.
As the old deacons would say, prop us up on every leaning side. Oh, Heavenly Father, we need you.
Right now.
We can't do it without you. As the old folks said a long time ago, you was a leaning post. We leaning on the post this morning. Thank you, oh God.
Thank you.
In the hour of bereavement, we're still needing on your holy, depending on your holy and righteous name, to carry us through our sorrow. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Help us to realize we must go on, regardless what's going on in this world right now. Help us to go on and help us to be able to stand. Keeping us.
Uh-huh.
Oh, Lord.
Yes.
Bless every family here.
Yes.
Oh, Heavenly Father.
Yes.
Because we're represented in your name.
Yes.
It's something about your name,
uh-huh,
Father,
yes,
that soothes everything.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
For every good deed that you do.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. As he comes to break the bread of life, let us have ears to hear. Let us have eyes to see. Father, don't take your love away from us. Don't take your love away from us. We need your love every moment, in every hour, in every step of the way. Bless the auxiliary of our church. Let us follow. Let our mind being stayed on you in these last perilous times. Oh, help us to go through. Help us to go through. We know with you we can do it all. And we'll be gone the last mile. Can't go no further. Give our souls a resting place. For to be joy and peace forevermore. In the name of Jesus we pray. And every heart said amen.
Amen.
Oh,
this morning's scripture will be the 34th Psalm.
Amen.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all of my fears. They looked upon him and were lightened, and their faces were not ashamed. This poor man cried, and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamped around about them that feared him and delivered him. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good, and blessed is the man that trusteth in him.
All
right. Oh, fear the Lord, ye his saints, for there is no want to them that fear him. The young lions do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord shall not want any good thing. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and hearers of his word. May we all stand for the preface to the Decalogue from all that dwell.
Thank you.
At this time, the usher will come forward for a benevolent offering.
Oh,
pray for each other. Pray for our sick and shut in. Pray for our youth. And let us please continue to keep Little Taylor Rose Lane lifted up in prayer as she gets a liver transplant.
Amen.
Also, we're going to ask prayer for our youth, our students that are traveling back to their destinations.
Yes.
Ask for traveling grace for them also. Amen. And also ask some traveling grace for us as we travel to our destination.
Yes.
And
yes.
Asking prayer for Reverend Hill as he travels to Brother Moses to deliver the message today.
Amen.
That God stand with him, beside him, in front of him, and in back of him, and give him the message that he needs to give to go out so that they can go out and tell others.
Yes.
And as Reverend Stembridge comes, let it also be done to him.
Mm-hmm.
That God gives him the message that we can go out and give others.
All
right. Please come. Father, for putting a man in place that can teach your word to us and know. So
there is a God.
Yeah.
And that God loves you regardless of what you go through. You can call on him at all times. Yeah. You can say, Jesus, I need you.
Yeah.
Jesus, I want you. Jesus, I need you to change my life and help me. Because I can't do it by myself. I can't do it by myself. My Heavenly Father, we need to learn how to love one another just like you love us. God, we need to learn how to forgive one another just like you forgive us each and every day. Our Heavenly Father, for all the members, and I can't just name them all, but for everyone that's going through their different problems, their different trials, I ask that you be a God of comfort. You be a God of a healing nature. You be a God that we know that will provide. So my Heavenly Father, I ask and I call on you at all times to walk with us. Talk with us.
Yes.
Teach us what we need to learn in order to survive this place.
Please.
Our Heavenly Father, we can't do nothing without you. And thank you so very much that on the fifth Sunday, there was enough of your disciples to just come here and want to learn more about you. Not worried about a fifth Sunday. Because God, I feel in my heart that if it was a sixth Sunday or a seventh Sunday, I'd still try to get him. Because I need you. We need you so very much in our life. God, we can't do nothing without you. So I ask you again, God, will you walk with me?
I'm dead.
Today, I want to especially dedicate this sermon today to Brother Johnny Hightower. And then after him, it's dedicated to each one of you all under the sound of my voice.
Well,
I see what the Lord is doing for him, and that's why I want to keep my eyes on and dedicated to him.
Amen.
Matthew, the 15th chapter.
start reading in the 25th verse. You find our take for today. One of the older preachers once years ago stood up and took a take. Before I read it, ain't nothing new in the scripture that you might not heard before. Matthew, the 25th chapter, beginning at the 25th verse, you'll find these readings. Then came she and worshiped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered her and said, it is not meet to take the children's bread and cast it to dogs. Jesus will put a roof on them. 27th verse. And she said, true, Lord, yet the dogs eat of the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Then Jesus answered and said to her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter was made whole from that very hour.
Amen.
Middle part of the 28th verse, you find our message. Jesus answered and said to her, O woman, great is thy faith. Want to talk a few moments today when you have great faith.
Amen.
Look at somebody and tell you need to have great faith.
You need to have great faith.
When we look here at our take today, we will find a woman coming to Jesus. And when she got to where Jesus was, we find her falling down, worshiping him, saying, Lord, help me. Instead of helping her right then, Jesus put a heavy quotation to her. Jesus said, it is not meet to take the children bread and cast to the dog. When Jesus said that, we find, Brother Walt, that this woman didn't give up on what she came to see Jesus for. She didn't drop her head and did like many walk away. But the woman said to Jesus, that true, Lord, yes, even the dog eat the crumb that fall from their master's table. When the woman said that to Jesus, he looked and saw how strong she was.
Amen.
Then he quoted to her, Brother Charles, oh woman, great is thy faith. Amen. That's why I said we got to have great faith.
Amen.
This take teaches us when we need Jesus. Sister Yvonne Needham come out, showed us need him to do something for us right then.
Yes.
We need to have, when we go to him, have that great faith.
Yes.
There's a difference between just having faith and having great faith.
Mm-hmm.
Brother,
amen.
Both of them almost mean the same, but there is a little bit different.
Yes, sir.
Brother, matter when we have faith, sometimes it limitates us to what we want Jesus to do for us.
Amen. Amen.
Sometimes faith means believe, but we believe for a certain period of time. Sometimes having faith, we'll do it for a little while. Sometimes when we have faith, we'll think that we don't have to take it but so far. After we didn't mess with it for a while, we'll give up on our faith. And then think that we don't have to go in the fuck. But today I want to tell you we need to have that great faith. Great faith is more persistent and more persuasion than just having faith.
Yeah.
When you have great faith, it means that you won't give up on something so easy.
Uh-huh. Yes. Come on, Pastor.
Great faith means you will deal with it a little more.
Yes.
Great faith means that when you go to Jesus, you take it to the limit.
Uh-huh.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In other words, you won't turn it loose too quick.
Yeah.
Now I want to tell you today, everybody knows when you have great faith.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Even when I go in the hospital or sick room and see a person, I know what kind of faith they have.
Uh-huh.
Now, if you just have faith, it's hard to deal with.
Uh-huh.
But when you have great faith, that means you are holding on and on.
Yeah.
That means you won't turn loose so quick.
Uh-huh.
Look at the Bible, at the book of Luke, you'll find the 7th chapter talks about a man that had great faith.
Well.
He talked about the centurion man who had a servant that was, he loved so dear, but his servant had become ill.
Well.
He was at the point of death, but the centurion had heard about Jesus.
Yes.
He had so much faith in himself that Jesus was going to heal his good servant till he didn't go to Jesus himself.
Yeah.
Read your Bible when you get home, the 7th chapter, the first through the 12th verse, you'll find that my Bible said he found some old Jews and said, y'all go and find Jesus.
Yes.
My stay here with the 6th service.
Uh-huh.
The old Jews went to Jesus and their faith was so great until when they spoke to Jesus, Jesus just looked at them.
Uh-huh.
Knew they had their great faith that they had gotten from somebody else.
Yes.
And when he got that great favor, told Jesus about the centurion, said, come and hear his servants. My Bible said that Jesus hear him right there on the spot.
Yes.
And when he hear that servant, Jesus kind of looked around at the crowd.
Yes.
And said to them, said, I was doing something else, but I hadn't seen such a great faith in a man.
Uh-huh.
So I want to tell you today, no matter what you have, when you go to Jesus, don't go there tippy-toe.
Uh-huh.
Go there when you want to do something for you to have great faith.
Yes, sir.
Be like the man was in Mark, the 2nd chapter. He was paralyzed, but he kept moving, and he started moving, and he got that great faith and said, you know what? I heard about Jesus. I'm going to him, and he's going to hear for me.
Uh-huh.
Yes. He had such great faith, but Charles, until he found him for help and said, take me to Jesus.
Yes.
Uh-huh. While they were there, took the father to get ready to take him to Jesus, this man didn't even get up out of his bed.
Uh-huh.
He had so much faith and told him, so you know what? My master gonna hear me while I'm still lying in my bed.
Yes. Yes.
And I thought about it today, if you have that faith in God,
uh-huh.
You know what happened? He can hear you wherever you are.
Yes.
All you gotta do is just get me to Jesus. And I know he'll heal me.
Uh-huh.
I don't know about you, this hell when he got to the crowd with Jesus, how would Jesus was, the crowd was so low.
Yes.
Y'all heard the story, but that man still lying on the bed with great faith.
Yes.
Until he said, you can't take me to the door, take me behind the house, and I go on top of the house,
yes,
and I go down in the room.
Yes. Yes.
Stop by to tell you when you have. I don't care how you get to Jesus, where you got to crawl, creep, jump, or whatever, as long as you get there. Then my kids are here, I'll take care of you. Just come on and try to find Jesus.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But when you get there, have
great faith.
Yeah. I hear Brother Walt all the time praying that when he leave home, he ain't got himself all built up.
Yeah.
He ain't got faith, but he got great faith.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
He got confidence in that as he drive, as he work, the God was gonna take care of him.
Yeah.
Because he built himself up well, great faith.
Yes, sir.
Let me tell you, man, you got to have that great faith.
Yeah.
See, all of us about have faith.
Amen.
Have faith. Mm-hmm. It's all right to have faith in God.
Yes.
Your faith will keep you close to the Lord.
Yeah.
Your faith will keep you calling on the Lord.
Yes.
Your faith will keep you believing in Jesus.
Yes, sir.
But when you sure enough need to be healed or blessed right then, you got to jack it up a little bit. You got to have what we call great faith. Make sure you got enough to take it to the Lord. See, great means you done something better than the average.
Yeah.
Anytime somebody said great job, means you done did your best.
Yeah.
When somebody said, I appreciate what you done, that means they stayed there until they took care of your situation.
Yeah.
Yes. When somebody has them there, they pat you on the back and tell you, go on here, be all right.
Yeah.
But when you got great faith in you, you will hang in there to make sure they is all right.
Yes, sir.
Do I good to have
great faith?
Great faith. Go home tonight when you take time. You ain't got to worry about football, but read the 15th chapter of Matthew.
All right, yeah. All
right. You'll find that where I was summoning the other day, 15th chapter, starting around the 21st verse.
Amen.
You'll find that this is a story about Jesus and a Canaanite woman.
Yes. Uh-huh.
She was called a Canaanite woman because she was from the land of Canaan.
Uh-huh.
If you look in the history of Canaan, you'll find out that some call that the lowland.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Land that nobody really want to hang around.
Mm-hmm.
Canaan was that land that way out in the back part of nowhere.
Yeah.
A place where people did their kind of own thing.
Mm-hmm.
Out there, they were almost kind of like, you want to almost call them uncivilized.
Yeah.
They out there, they worship out of God.
Uh-huh.
You go way back to Genesis, and they told old Isaac, said, now when you leave, they told Esau, now when you leave, go over yonder, don't marry no Canaanite woman.
Uh-huh. Yes,
you coming from a tough bunch over there.
Uh-huh.
But if I break it down, you know, I can break it down and say part of the city. You don't want to go over there. They might thin your hood,
Kev.
Yeah, they got your car over there. Man, bruh, snap rope to a certain place one time and meet somebody in the city, had to cut through and go through a little bad spot. Middle of the day, about 4 o'clock. Middle of the streets.
All right.
Amen.
Three or four things were going on.
Uh-huh.
All right.
Brother Mammon and little children were bad over here with the tricycle. We couldn't hardly get through. Got a little further. Old and young guy with no shirt on, middle of the street playing cards, and we had to wake our way through.
Mm-hmm.
Canaan, I'm over there. Kind of bad.
Yeah.
Jesus would give it a deal with a Canaanite. It's read the Bible, want to learn your Bible. My Bible always going to tell you where somebody come from.
Oh, yeah.
4th chapter John, when Jesus met the woman at the well, they called her the Samaritan woman because she a from Samaria.
Uh-huh.
More time I meet somebody, they ask where you from, I got to tell them where I'm from.
Uh-huh.
So here it is here that Jesus was getting ready to deal with this Canaanite woman. This story here almost, we want to know, Sister Green, that almost didn't happen in the Bible.
Amen.
Only reason why it happened in the Bible was that Jesus just happened to be in the right place at the right time.
Amen.
That's what I like about Jesus, brother. High time, I don't care what happened, he always seem to be in the right place at the right time.
Uh-huh.
My Bible tells me that Jesus had them went way out yonder near a place called Tiberias City.
Uh-huh.
Way out yonder by the coast. And the reason why Jesus was out there, my Bible tells me in the history of my Bible said, he was trying to get away from that crowd which had been following him.
Yeah.
Some believe, matter that Jesus was tired.
Mm-hmm.
It needed some rest.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know tonight, every now and then that Jesus also got tired.
Mm-hmm.
So here he is, way out yonder, and Tyre is sitting way out yonder, almost near the land of Canaan.
Mm-hmm.
People tired because if you go back to that 14th chapter, Jesus had just fed the 5,000.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I would have had Matthew or somebody catching people here now. It's hard enough to feed 100 or 200.
Amen. Amen.
But here he was feeding.
Yes, sir.
After he fed the 5,000, he had to get on the ship and go across the sea.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But out there he ran into a storm. He had to calm the storm.
Yes.
I know he was getting a little tired.
Yeah.
Because every now and then when we drive our car and run into a little hard rain, we had to wrestle with it and come out. We tired.
Yeah.
Then after he did all of that and got on the other side, he met some Pharisees. He had to deal with them because they want to argue with him that your men had eaten without washing their hands. Jesus had to tell him it's not what go nasty would go in your mouth that defile a man, but what come out of your body.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jesus got through all that. He was tired, so he went well over the 70 tyrant, got over there and tipped in a house. And didn't want nobody to know he was in the house.
Right.
He thought he was going to get some rest, but walk. But one thing I want to tell you is, Jesus knew that he can't hide.
Well.
Somebody always going to need Jesus.
Yes.
Yeah. Tyrion and Sid with that land way over there, and here he is in his backward land, and almost in the land of Canaan.
Yes.
But when he got ready to go over there, something happened with Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Sometimes I want to be light to my mind.
All right.
I find me a Western.
Yeah.
And when I find me a Western, and I let get one of them kind where one of them guys ought to be put it tough.
Yeah.
And being put it tough.
All right,
brother. Yes, sir.
His reputation precede him where he's going.
Amen.
When somebody get there and call his name, they all jump back. Because the reputation start to spread.
Yeah.
Well, that had was with Jesus.
Amen.
His reputation or his fame was spread all over the land.
Yes.
Even though he was dealing back there with the Jews at that time, his fame was still spread and everybody had heard about who he was.
Uh-huh.
What Jesus was able to do.
Uh-huh.
So now way out there, these two little cities sitting by the beach, Tyre and Sidon, Jesus is out there to get some rest, but when he went out there, his fame had beat him out there.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
He was the one that didn't know him, but they had heard about what he was able to do.
Uh-huh.
They had heard that Jesus could cast out demons.
Uh-huh.
He could heal the sick.
Uh-huh.
And all them folks out there that no doubt that when they heard about Jesus, began bringing their sick folk to Jesus.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Then as you begin to hear them, my Bible tells me that somebody from way out, John, in the land of Canaan, a lady had a daughter there. She came to Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Oh, when you came to Jesus, that no doubt when you came to Jesus, she had been wrestling with that daughter, had been going everywhere trying to get her daughter healed.
Yes.
Said her daughter had a demon in her and could the demon one turn her daughter loose.
Yes.
So the woman then wrestled all them Canaanites, they about just as tough as she was, saying, don't come here, we have our own problem.
Yeah, yeah.
They ain't never had none of you all before. Got a little problem going from my head way up. I got mine too. So this woman here heard about Jesus.
Yes.
Being close to her territory.
Uh-huh.
Before I leave you today, I want to challenge you today. You might not want to study your Bible.
Well,
some of you might not want to know about the Lord.
Well,
but if you don't study your Bible, want to know about it, at least you ought to be heard about it.
Yes, right. Sir.
Heard about what Jesus is able to do.
Amen.
You ought to be heard about it. See, I want a little part of it.
Amen.
Let me tell you a story before I leave about a lady. Walked around the community a long time and she was doing all right in her payday here.
Well, well.
Had a heaven straight and a couple dollars in her pocket, but maybe she was doing all right.
Amen.
Didn't try to find out too much about the Lord.
Well.
But one thing she found out, woke up one day, she hadn't got way up in age.
Amen.
Health had started getting a little weak.
Well.
And then she began to get a little frail, and she was almost scared to go out of her house.
Amen.
But one day some missionary went by there, might have been Sister Green, and told her, have great faith in God.
Yes.
That lady fell down on her knees and called on Jesus.
Yes.
And she built up her faith in the Lord, and he said she'll go out a little bit and go out a little bit more.
Amen.
But the woman found out in her old age by trusting in God and got that great faith in God. Praying, saying, protect me, Lord, keep me safe wherever I go.
Yes.
Later one day decided she'll go downtown, went out to the bus stop,
yes.
Sitting on the bench all by herself.
Yeah.
But then just Diane, she kind of looked around on the left, thought she saw a man on the left, thought she saw a man on the right.
Yeah.
Had to told the Lord, said, you take care of me.
Yes.
Couldn't hardly wait till the bus to come. When the bus came, opened the door, she got ready to step on, but she thought she saw a man step in ahead.
Uh-huh.
Then looked back like somebody was coming in behind.
Uh-huh.
Woman said, I thought I was scared, but I didn't pray that seemed like somebody following me.
Well.
Went out to the mall, to the store. Every time they looked around, she saw like a man over here. Looked like a man over there.
Amen.
Woman said she came back home and got on the bus. One got on the front, one got on behind.
Uh-huh.
One sat behind her, rode the bus, and when they got off, one stepped off in the front, one stepped off behind.
Uh-huh.
Got home, they followed her to the door.
Uh-huh.
Went in the house and prayed what she said in the morning, my call to preach.
Uh-huh.
Called Rev and said, Rev, I didn't got to be afraid.
Uh-huh.
What wrong with you? Said, I was doing all right when I was by myself.
Yeah.
But Miss Green told me to have great faith.
Yeah.
And then I built it up and said, now I told the Lord to protect me because I'm getting old and I need somebody to go with me. Preacher said, well, if somebody followed you and got you scared, had you called the police?
Yes.
The woman said, well, I done called my him two or three times. They said him for hours, but they can't find nobody.
Uh-huh.
Preacher said, well, ma'am, you mean to tell me you don't know who it is?
Yeah.
Who that is following you?
Yeah.
The woman looked at him and smiled and said, well, Rev, can you tell me who it is?
Yeah.
Preacher said, yeah, David told me about her a long time ago.
Yeah.
David told me, said, did you turn the song, the 23rd Psalm?
Yes.
And begin to look at the sixth verse.
Yeah.
David said, surely in goodness shall follow me.
Yeah.
I was trying to follow you with two angels.
Yeah.
Two angels called surely in goodness.
Yeah.
Goodness and mercy.
Yeah.
The woman said, well, I know what to do when I go to the store again.
Uh-huh.
When I sit down, I tell one, sit on the right.
Uh-huh.
And I tell one, sit on the left. When I step on the bus,
yeah.
You go on ahead, you come on behind me.
Yeah.
Every time in, you got to use your great faith,
yeah.
And God will take care of you.
Yeah.
Have to try the Lord.
Yeah.
Give me to my story here to get ready to close.
Jesus.
This woman said, I'm going to try Jesus.
Jesus.
Having wrestled with that dog.
Yeah.
Then she heard that Jesus was over yonder.
Uh-huh.
I heard Brother Paul say, if it's a sick of a seventh Sunday,
yeah.
I'm going over yonder.
Right.
Over yonder where Jesus is.
Yeah.
The woman got herself up. I don't know that she brought her daughter, but my Bible said she came to where Jesus was.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And when she got there, my Bible said she worshiped him and said, Lord, help me.
Yeah.
My daughter had a demon.
Yeah.
But Jesus kept on doing what he doing.
Yeah.
My Bible tells me that old crazy disciples,
yeah.
Old Peter, James, and John,
yeah.
Told Jesus, tell that woman, get away from us.
Yeah.
She crying out too loud.
Yeah.
But I thought need God help.
Yes.
No matter how loud you cry.
Yes.
No matter how loud you holler.
Yes.
Not, that's because he'll come in and try to help you.
Yes.
The woman kept getting louder and louder.
Yeah.
And I heard Jesus said, Lord, lady, you got my attention.
Jesus.
But I was sitting here for the Lord's children of Israel.
Uh-huh.
And she said, you know, I can't stop this thing and take my bread and give it to you. But I had to catch it to the dog.
Yeah.
But I heard the lady say, well, you know, even a dog can eat a crumb fall from the table.
Yeah.
And she said, well, I need your help right now.
Yeah.
With tears in her eyes.
Yeah.
Kept calling on Jesus.
Yeah.
And Jesus said, this woman here ain't going to leave me alone.
Yeah.
So I'm about to tell you, when you show up, need the Lord.
Yeah.
You get a hold to the Lord.
Yeah.
Get a hold on the Lord.
Jesus.
Make sure everything is all right.
Yeah.
The woman said, I'm going to hold on to you,
Jesus,
until you give me my blessing.
Yeah.
But Jesus said, well, I go ahead on and bless you right now.
Yeah.
He said, oh, woman, great is thy faith.
Yeah.
I'm about to tell you when you're in your heart pillow,
yeah,
when you're on your sick bed,
yeah,
when you don't have no other help,
yeah,
you go down on your knees,
yeah,
and have that great faith.
Yeah.
He will. Take care of me. Sometimes, kick it in high gear. This faith ain't quite enough.
Yeah.
But apart when the woman came to Jesus, she had her mind made up that Jesus gonna heal my daughter. When the faith came, she said, Lord, help me. But when Jesus died, he was doing something else. When she came back that second time, she fell down before him. And then cried out, Lord, I need help.
Yeah.
So I just want to tell you today, when you need help,
yeah,
I'm talking to the Lord.
Yeah.
Well, let me bag up a little bit. When you know you need a job.
Yeah.
Go to the unemployment place to get a job.
Uh-huh.
You stay there and beg and plead, whether you get it or not.
Yes.
You might have to come up with your head hanging. Sometimes when you want something in, you need a bag.
Yeah.
You beg, you cry,
yeah,
you hope,
yeah,
that they'll give you what you need.
Yeah.
But I got something easy for you.
Yeah.
When you need the Lord to help you. Get all by yourself.
Yeah.
I'm picking on Walter. They say go down to his secret room.
Spend
time with the Lord.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something before I go. Don't wait till you get dead sleep to talk to the Lord. Because you get on your knees, you gotta want to go to sleep.
Yeah.
But make sure you're wide awake when you need Jesus.
Yeah.
Make sure you got your mind well made up. And you got time to talk with him.
Yeah.
When that lady came, Brother Matthew, she had her mind made up.
Yes, sir.
You're gonna heal my. Well, I can't say you're going to. She had her mind, had enough faith that you're gonna heal her daughter.
Yes.
When Jesus cried to her 10, he didn't hear her. He was doing something else. She didn't leave Jesus. She stayed right there.
Yes, sir.
Then Jesus came back and talked to her a little bit. Told her I was sitting here for the how for the children of Israel, but he was wheeled in the land of Canaan.
Yeah.
And the woman here was persistent, and she was persuasive, and she would not leave till she got an answer.
Amen.
And then he had to cry to her, oh woman. That's all right.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Sometimes they want what you call my name, but I don't care what they call me, I'm going to hear me. Oh woman, great is your faith. So long you keep your faith pumped up for the Lord,
yeah,
he'll hear you,
yes,
and he will hear you. He hears this lady who will live way over yonder. Don't you know he can hear us right here in his sanctuary? I'm sitting down now, but I stand up here most every Sunday, and I look out here at my flock. And when I see one come say, I need this, I need that, and we pray, and Brother Matthew said in Sunday school,
And God, hear and answer our prayer. And I see the smile on your face.
Yes.
I see what you've been through. I see your burden been lifted. I don't know about but the Lord. Let me stop now. Let me open the doors of the church. Somebody said, well, no visitor, but who knows what might happen. If the spirit hits you, knock you down, say, run you down, he shake his hand. The doors of the church is open. Whoever you're saying, quiet, it's all right with me. I'm good, Brother High Tower, ready to sing my song, give him not today.
Amen.
The doors are now open.
Thank you.
peace of God, love of this son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit, a rest, rule, and abide within you now and forever.
Yeah.
Let all of God's children say,